Isn't blowing up voting machines kind of extreme?
Hell no!
It's like Josh said, we buy time for the election. It's a civic service, essentially.
With the machine.
I'm out.
Great. Hey, we put together a video using the stuff you got in the penthouse. Check it out.
Citizens, Invite Corporation has been using your sacred vote as a plaything, targeting you individually. Invite manipulated your emotions to give support to their puppet, Mark Thrust. But DedSec hacked into Invite and changed their algorithms. Polls reversed instantly. Invite, desperate to elect Thrust, resorted to their own form of hackery. Here, Invite CEO Mary Catskill delivers a virus destined for voting machines to Mark Thrust himself. The election has been its time to think. Do not allow yourselves to be manipulated. DedSec implores you to think before you vote. DedSec has given you the truth. Do what you want.
Oh!
Our followers think nailing Thrust is the big win here. But it's only the frosting on the cake.
People are gonna be doubting their own opinions now. Nobody's going to admit to getting played with this election. But every ProThrust voter is now wondering if they were. We've welded Bloom and the CTOS to the idea that big data is invasive and shitty.
Yep. One big invasive shitty cake.
You're terrible.
You love it.
What's up, Ray?
Joshua picked up something strange from the Galileo hack.
It's code, but the comments are in Chinese.
Tell me the Chinese didn't hack the satellite backbone already?
Not the satellite. The submarine cables connecting China and the U.S. That's not even the interesting drop-your-pants part. Bloom's been monitoring the hack.
Joshua says the hackers are stealing data and using it to make a mint on the New York Stock.
So? It's not the first time this happened.
Yeah, we'll get this. The program the hackers are using? Drumroll, Josh, please. Pattern recognition software. Sure as shit looks like Bellwether to me.
And Bloom knows? So why are they sitting on it?
Well, that's why we're talking. We have nothing solid to go on, except our Chinese hackers use their access to pre-clear a cargo ship landing in San Francisco. Their shipping containers just arrived at the port.
I'll check it out.
What the fuck do we have here?
Satara, what's the container number I'm looking for?
LV-426.
Oh, seriously? You testing my geek food?
A bit, yeah. It starts with SIBU-707.
Okay, I see it. But I got other containers. Damn, we the committee, gonna burn it down. But that's gonna bust you in the mouth with the chorus now. Calm down. Calm the fuck down.
Fuck. Riddle me this. Who around here is Chinese and deals in human trafficking?
Anti-shoe boys for sure.
Yeah. Well, it's some high-end human smuggling like I ain't never seen before. His container is nicer than my last apartment. I'm sending you a picture.
Got it. Who is he and why does he have a bloody nose?
Noodle Translate isn't his friend. And he's not your run-of-the-mill cargo either.
Not sure what I can do with it.
Let's see if you can match his face online. My guess, he's got an education if they went to all this trouble.
Right. I'll start with Chinese schools and get back to you if I find something.
Okay. Oh, and by the way, welcome to America.
Poke, legal guy. Wait, Molly, see, don't want me. I'm not going to touch you, don't go sound here.
Marcus, I found your guy.
What you got?
Graduate of Shanghai Jiao Tong University. He's got a double master's in statistic and business. He's a quant.
They definitely need him to number crunch that stock market data, which means the Auntie Shoe Boys are in the business of insider trading.
I have a contact in Chinatown who's connected with the Auntie Shoe Boys. I'm sending you his coordinates. Maybe he can help you get answers.
Pero gallo que veis se les para en su tierra y aparte les canta resulta más gallo, calma, guacamayo, yo no te voy a matar. ¿Quién mantiene a la familia si me mandan encerrar? Pero atente, bocón, todos conocemos gente. A ti te conocemos y tú no eres delincuente. Siente armar, entonces véngame a buscar. Porque yo no tengo tiempo de te tiro pa' sonar. Yo tengo un par de balas en la taus que quisieran conocerte. Y no ando nada más que en la calle quiero verte. Que si en la primera vez corriste con suerte. Y la muerte a la puerta llama más fuerte. Tengo un par de balas que quisieran conocerte. Y no ando nada más que en la calle quiero verte. Que si en la primera vez corriste con suerte. Y la muerte a la puerta llama más fuerte.
Me declararon la guerra.
Hey, you know this guy? Yeah, you're just full of attitude, aren't you? Look, I know the Auntie Shoe boys are bringing him in. I'm trying to find out why.
No, I don't fucking know him. We don't all know each other.
Satara said you could help me out. Give me something here.
Why didn't you say so? Auntie Shoe has an office in an import-export company on Gold Street. They keep records there. But you tell Satara this makes us even.
Yeah, yeah. Thanks. Heads up, I'm checking up on a lead in Chinatown. I think it's an Auntie Shoe safe house or something. I'll let you know if I find anything.
Okay, keep an eye out for anything we can use related to the stock market hack.
Now this is promising. Let's see what you're hiding.
You got anything good?
Documents.
You read Chinese?
Nah, but I do read maps and diagrams.
Maps and diagrams of what?
Looks like a floating server farm. Computer nodes, generators. They're in international waters somewhere near the China-US cable.
The Pacific Fleet's been chasing boats and submarines away from that thing for years. But that's a lot of wet to cover.
Not when they also feed you coordinates. Thank you, Auntie Shoe Boys.
Great. Now get out of there.
He's still around. Find him.